So dear learners, in this video we will be start discussing about the object oriented design process. So under this we are going to start with our first stage, that is system, context and interaction. Okay, so basically there are five different stages are there in object oriented design process is concerned. Okay, so here the common activities in this process includes those five stages here. Just have a look at these five stages. The very first one is define the context and modes of use of the system. Okay, so the meaning here is it consists of two important parts here. One is defining the context and also defining what the modes of use of the system. So here the meaning here is in this first stage of this object oriented design, as per the title of this first stage is concerned, whatever the software system that we are going to design, for that we need to define the context. Context in the sense what? The environment in which our proposed software system is supposed to be get used. Means environment in the sense what? Okay, my software system is supposed to be get used along with, there are many other existing different systems along with that in that particular environment. So that will be get represented with what? The context here. Okay, at the same time the modes of use of the system means it will give a dynamic nature. It means that how exactly my system is going to be get interact with all these different systems. See there. So it means that in this particular first stage, so we are going to represent my overall software system is to be get developed in terms of this context model, that is the static nature. Okay, what are all the different what other systems with which my system is supposed to work, and also the modes of use of the system, meaning that okay, the dynamic nature, how my system is going to interact with the surrounding systems. Okay, then the second stage is design the system architecture. Okay, so once we are going to build up these kind of context models and interaction models in the first stage, then we will go for defining the system architecture. System architecture means here, so we are going to define the different subsystems and components of that particular newly software that we have planned, and their relationship will be get defined over here. Then the third stage is identifying the principal system objects. So now as my overall concept itself is object oriented design, then automatically I need to identify and define the principal system objects, which are the main integral part of my software system is to be get developed. Then the fourth one is we need to develop the different types of the design models. Okay, then last one is what? Specify the object interface. So here we need to define the how one object is going to be get interfaced with what? The other object, or one component or one subsystem is going to be get interfaced with what? Another system, so which will make my full working system. Okay, so like this these five stages have to be get completed, which are the part of object oriented design. So in this particular video we will be concentrating on the first stage here. And another important thing is to illustrate this overall process activities, we have taken an example of wilderness weather station. So I think so this is the third case study that we had discussed in our one of our previous video. Please I suggest all of you to go back to that particular video and clearly understand that wilderness weather station. Okay, so that video will clearly tell about what exactly this weather station mapping system, which is a kind of software based system responsible for generating the weather information or weather data or weather report. Is it clear? Okay, so my first stage is, just have a look at there, that is system context and interactions. Okay, so here the system context in the sense what? Here we are going to understand the relationship between the software that is being designed and its external environment. Okay, which is very much essential for deciding how to provide the required system functionality and how to structure what the system to communicate with its environment. Why? Because just now we told that in case of system context is concerned, my particular software or system is going to work along with the many other existing systems surrounding in that particular environment. Okay, so that we need to identify. Okay, and then we need to understand what relationship will be get exhibited between them. Okay, and also so here we are going to understanding the context also let help us to what? To establish the boundaries of the system. Okay, so where exactly my system boundary is there, so that I will come to know that. So that setting up this particular boundaries always help us to decide, so what features are implemented in the system being designed and what features are in other associated system. So that we will clearly come to know that whether any feature to be get implemented, it should be a part of my system or it may be a part of what? The other system which is surrounding to this particular system. So the decision can be taken very easily. Is it clear? Okay. So in this particular context and interaction model, as a first stage of my object oriented design is concerned, so here we are going to build a system context model. It is nothing but a structural model that demonstrate what the other systems in the environment of the system being developed, and also we are going to represent my system in terms of its interaction model, which is a type of what, the dynamic model that shows how my system is going to interact with its environment as it is used. Okay, in both different perspective we are going to design our system. Okay, so as an example, just have a look at here. So this is a context model that we have represented for our weather station. Okay, this is the system context. System context means we have already told it's a structural model. It's a type of static, and here it is clearly showing that. So here is my weather station. Along with my weather station, okay, a supporting system that will be acting as, that is called control system. Then there will be a satellite arrangement. Then also what, and weather information system. So these are all the three different systems. Along with that, my weather station is going to work. Okay, so this is how the context that we have identified, so which will reveal that not only weather station is not an independent component here, apart from that, so we need some other surrounding systems like control system, satellite and weather information systems are also what, the surrounding system that we have identified. Okay, with which, along with that, we need to work out with what our weather station is concerned here. Okay, so this is what the context model will represent. So similarly, along with that context model, we told that we need to represent in terms of their interactions there. So that interaction can be represented by using what, the use case model here. You can observe. Okay, so use case model is a one type of dynamic representation of a system model, so which consists of actors and interaction. So here, just have a look at there. This weather station is going to be represented with this use case, means a weather that is weather information system. It can do two type of interaction, that is report weather and also what, report status. Whereas this control system is going to have a different interaction like restart, shutdown, reconfigure, okay, power save, remote control of what, my weather station. Okay, so these are all the different interactions that we can do with what, our weather station here. But that can be done with the help of the system called what, weather information system and control systems. Okay, so this is how this particular diagram will tell that. Okay, these are the different interactions that can be done with the weather station. Okay, by having a relationship with what, the weather information system that is as a subsystem, and control system as another subsystem. Okay, and this use case diagram is not only a sufficient just to depict the overall interaction of what, the different activities here, because we have already told that every use case diagram is to be get supported with the use case description. So here, for example, say we have taken one example for one interaction called report weather. Okay, you can observe here. So report weather is a one example of an interaction. Okay, so which will be taking place between what, with weather information system is concerned. So just have a look at there how we have written that use case description here. So here that use case description should comes with different titles here. That is nothing but, first one is the name of the use case, that is what, report weather. Then who are the actors which are involved? The actors involved is weather information system and weather station. These are the two actors. Then what's the description, means what exactly this report weather interaction means, that should be clearly explained here. So just I will read out, just you go through this and listen to this particular overall description very clearly here. So here the weather station sends a summary of what, weather data that has been collected from the instruments in the collection period to the weather information system. The data sent are maximum, minimum and average ground and air temperature, maximum, minimum, average pressure, maximum, minimum and average speed, okay, then total rainfall, then wind direction, which is sampled at 5 minutes interval. So this is all about what the description of a report whether. So report whether is not simply reporting something or some data there. Clearly we need to mention here what are the different types of weather data that should be included in that report. Just have a look at there. So here we have included ground and air temperature, okay, pressure, and then wind speed, rainfall, see there. And not only that, every data will come up with minimum, maximum and average values, okay. So the description clearly we have mentioned, and also all this data have been taken as a sampled at every 5 minutes interval. Okay, so like that throughout the day the samples is to be get collected and that report should be get sent. Okay, and what is the stimulus? Stimulus in the sense here, what events make this particular interaction is going to be happen? Is it clear? So here the weather information system is going to establish what? A satellite communication link with that, with the help of that, okay, the weather station with what? With the weather station, that link will be get established and is going to request what? The transmission of the data. So here that satellite communication is going to act as what? The stimulus. Okay, then what is the response here? Means the output of this interaction, that is the summarized data is sent to the weather information system. So it means that from the weather station, okay, whenever this report weather interaction is going to be taken place, the weather inform that weather report, that summarized data will be sent to the weather information system. Is it clear? So this is how we are going to clearly describe one particular interaction. Okay, so like this you have to write the use case description for all these interactions. Okay, so this is what the first stage of object oriented design is going to be get consist of. So here we need to represent the context model, that is the structural model, which will give the static representation of my overall system to be get developed. And also we need to define the interaction models, which involves this use case models along with the description of what the use cases for every interaction is to be get explained. Okay, so that is going to finish up the first stage of what? Object oriented design, that is nothing but system, defining the system context and its interaction. Okay, hope the topic has been understood by all of you. Thank you.